I'm using DrawThings, the Stable Diffusion client for Mac and iOS. It's of course free in the app stores. Today I'm showing a couple of community scripts that are now available inside DrawThings, so very easy to add and use. The two scripts are Detailer and Single Detailer. Now, Detailer scripts automate the process of finding the face or faces, zooming in, creating a blending mask, and re-rendering over the face at higher resolution. I'll show you how to use them, explain the differences, and how to customize them with a built-in JavaScript editor. Don't worry, you don't need to know JavaScript to use this tutorial. It's also an introduction to using scripts in DrawThings.
Yes.
At the end of the video, I'll show you how to do this kind of detailing manually without the script, because once you see how easy this is, you'll want to fix hands and anything else in the image that needs more detail. You will level up your images. To add these scripts to DrawThings, open the scripting menu and scroll down to the bottom where it lists all the community scripts. Click once on each script and a copy is created in your own scripts list. It's alphabetical. We can also create a new script and paste the script into it, or edit right here in the scripting interface, which is a little bare bones, but when the script is valid, we'll see it turn to colors to show the different scripting classes. All right, now we use Single Detailer on an existing image. I'm gonna select an image in my project history, one where the face is maybe not so good, and I'm gonna add it to the canvas. Now this works best with the original model and matching configuration, so usually you just do this as you go and everything's already loaded. I'll run Single Detailer script. Remember, Single Detailer here is for the single image that's on the canvas. I lose control of the UI while the script is active and rendering, but when it's done, our original parameters should be restored. Now the thumbnail will show the close-up, so you'll know which images have already been detailed. And I notice sometimes the image doesn't always return to center afterwards, so you can always do that by hand. And export the image as usual, but I like to copy the full image and paste it back into my project. And sometimes I even delete the original so I don't get them confused. When I choose to save or copy, I get a pop-up warning me about the image size because it used infinite canvas and the image can be very large. DrawThings has resized my canvas image since we zoomed in and rendered again at 1024 by 1024, so the main image has been rescaled to accommodate that level of detail. Now we have the option to save the full resolution of the infinite canvas, but I usually scale the new render down to the original render size. Now I'm gonna open the detailer script. Most developers will add any user configurable parameters to the top of the script with a label and explanation. In most cases, you don't need to understand the code to edit these simple parameters. So let's take a fast look at these. Now, detailer is automatic. It runs in one of two modes. The first is batch rendering and detailing as it goes. So the preset is to render 100 batch images. It will detail every face in each image. But of course we can hit stop to stop the script. So it doesn't need to be 100. Now the other operating mode is running detailer on every image in a folder. So this parameter sets a specific directory that DrawThings has access to. That means it's probably in your photos folder. And every image in it will get detailed. We have an optional detailer prompt that can be different from the main prompt, and an optional detailer suffix prompt that adds instructions to the end of the main prompt. We can override render parameters like steps and text guidance, image-to-image strength, and render size. Now, how many faces will be detailed? The default is 99 per image. And we can also set specific LoRa and control nets that activate only in the detailer pass. Remember this, it'll be important later. And lastly, we can assign an output folder to save the images. A single detailer has all the same options except the batch rendering and the photo directory, because single detailer just runs on the image that's in the canvas. Single here means single image, not single face. It will still do up to 99 faces. Well, I'm leaving everything at the default, so when we're done, just click the X to close the script editor. One of the nice things with the script is it reports its settings into the console log, and we can open the console by clicking on the text that appears at the bottom of the screen after the render is done. Now, this might seem a little extra, but what I want you to notice is how the script set the mask blur to 50. And that's not possible with the user interface. Our mask blur slider only goes up to 15. So if you want to do this without the script, we need a workaround to set that parameter higher. So I'm going to go to the top of the parameter menu and open the configuration presets and choose copy configuration. In a text editor, I can paste the config and it's just a big JSON array. Now, once I have the mask blur, I'll change that value to 50 and then copy the whole config back into the presets menu using paste configuration. And now notice that the mask blur slider is set to 50. The other necessary parameters for detailing are to set the mask blur offset to negative 50. Our mask is basically the border of the render window. Mask blur offset is moving it out further to accommodate the big mask blur. Now the last trick is image to image, and we'll set the strength to 40% because that's the same as the script. I'll also square the render size so it's rendering 1024 by 1024. And now I'm free to roam around my image and add details to anything, not just faces. I just zoom in, leaving space around the object. I don't need to use the eraser or the selection tool. Just frame the object within the render window. And I can adjust the prompt to describe it, whatever I'm detailing, and then render. And I can do this again and again. If I have multiple people in the scene, I'll adjust my prompt for each face. I can even swap out a character Laura for each face, or maybe the mood board to use with a control, like IP adapter, so the correct face ends up on the right person. Now that's all I have time for today. So give me a like if you think this video will help others, and subscribe if you want to be notified of the next one. As usual, I hope you had a learn, and I will see you next time.